Well, holy shit, I am a fucking prophet. Last week we talked about the importance of accurate representation, now we get to talk why accurate representation has its downsides. Strap on in, folks. I get the feeling that this will get nasty really fast. Demi-chan is an anime about a biology teacher whose name I can't remember that lives in a world where, thanks to random genetic mutations, humanoid monster girls are a thing, and not until recently, these poor monster girls have gotten the obvious treatment. But now, as we live in a progressive society, they stopped lynching them, and now they slowly blend into everyday life. The aforementioned monster girls, or demis as they are casually called, are as followed. A highly energetic vampire girl that might as well be our show's protagonist, a Dullahan from some province so far that it might as well be a foreign country, a snow woman who somehow managed to be irrelevant while getting the most screen time dedicated to her, and a succubus, or as I like to call her. How the hell can we insert fan service in this serious anime? There are several secondary characters, but they are either so banal or irrelevant to the overall story that I view even mere mentioning of them as an insult to my audience intelligence. Now, to be fair, I liked how the show seriously represented all possible problems these monster girls might have in your typical Japanese big city and your typical Japanese high school, even though mutations of said monster girls are more akin to disabilities than superpowers. It had almost zero blatant fan service, although a lot of just fuck already moments that sometimes made me feel like I'm playing some average visual novel and instinctively was ready to choose my route. The music, although an remarkable mix of piano and violin, was hitting every string required and was used sparely. So why can't I recommend this show, you might ask? The answer is, well, both easy and simultaneously hard. I'll explain as best as I can. You see, I have this somewhat silly belief that legacy is very important, and every product must have at least some impact on its audience, from the graphics of this movie were breathtaking, to this bounty bar's sweet and delicious. No matter how terrible or bland the product might be, every person has to feel some kind of emotion that will then define the product in his eyes. If the person liked what he experienced, he will become more interested in what you offer, and though he might disagree with you on something, he at least will form your core audience, so to say. The problem with this approach is that people's opinion on things often form from 1,000 various things, from small to big, from a headache and a growing depression to a good old blowjob and a pretty check. However, even if what you like and dislike depends almost entirely on your mood and general view on things, we can see trends that the majority like via sales numbers and Occam's razor. This is the reason why there's a lot of action flicks and shooters right now that look similar, if not downright identical to each other, and not enough melodramas and strategy games. And the reason why I'm explaining all of this is that when I was watching Demi-chan, I felt nothing. The characters never made me laugh or annoyed me like in Kimono Friends and Yojo Senki. I can retell you what happened in 5th episode of Umaru, ReZero and even Grimgar, but I can't remember what happened in 6th episode of this show, even though I finished watching it like, what, 4 hours ago? And while thinking why, I've come to a conclusion that the reason for this is that there was nothing here that genuinely hooked me. For all intents and purposes, I was watching a 12 episode documentary about why are not as bad as some people say they are and what sort of everyday problems they face, with moralization levels ranging from predictably righteous to fucking embarrassing. The only thing that I took from this story, even with all that I liked about it, was, well, good for you, I suppose. And I do not say that you shouldn't watch it. Maybe you're one of these demi-humans that finally wants to see himself represented and not bullied at least somewhere. Maybe you just want to see something not overly sexualized, and hell, maybe what I consider to be moralizing you'll find appealing. That is entirely normal, and I wouldn't hold a grudge against you. But the fact that this show was low on sales and probably has a small number of dedicated fans says a lot more about what majority thinks of your tastes than I or anybody else can ever say. But so that we wouldn't end this episode on a sour note, I have another fact that might persuade you to watch it. This show has a rape horse in it, and a show that has a rape horse is a good show. Occasionally.